Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome this morning, a very warm welcome if you're visiting our site. Welcome to all our scattered community of All Saints on this fifth Sunday after Pentecost. During the Pentecost season, we journey with Jesus through the Gospels. We sit at his feet, we hear what he has to say week by week. And today we hear those wonderful words, "Come to me," Jesus says. "Come to me if you're weary, come to me if you're scared, come to me if you're grieving, come to me if you're lonely. Come to me and I will give you rest." Sabbath rest is at the very heart of creation. And at this point, as COVID has changed our world, perhaps we have the opportunity to rethink how we live. How do we make God's principle of rest at the very heart of our lives? As you join us in worship today, if you have a prayer book, we'll begin on page 119. Or if you have the liturgy that we sent out, please join us. Please join us in the hymn singing and in the responses so that you are part of this Mass as we worship together on this fifth Sunday after Pentecost. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God's kingdom now and forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The sentence for this fifth Sunday after Pentecost. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. Let us join together in the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, confident in God's forgiveness. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, your Son, Jesus Christ, has taught us that what we do for the least of his brothers and sisters, we do also for him. Give us the will to serve others, as he was the servant of all, who gave up his life and died for us, yet lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We will now have the readings of the day.
A reading from the prophet Zechariah, chapter 9. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he. Humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off. And he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. For the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Beginning at the 16th verse. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time, Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, And no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. For the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us now together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now pray for the world and for the Church.
Gracious and merciful God, you have promised rest to the weary and relief to the heavy laden. Hear the prayers we bring for your people. We pray for those weighed down by the hardship of daily life, for those who live in poverty without adequate food or shelter, for those in places of war, civilians, soldiers, and refugees. Relieve their burdens, that all your people may live in dignity and peace. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those wearied by responsibility in society, for those without the resources to fulfill their tasks, those whose dreams are shattered, and those whose visions others do not share. Renew their spirits, that they may find their strength in you. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those exhausted by overwork or the responsibility of care, for carers of young children, of the disabled and the infirm, for those unable to provide for them, for their families or themselves. Lighten their loads, that they may know your encouragement and support. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those burdened by guilt, self-doubt, anxiety, or despair, for those unable to leave behind their past, for those afraid of the present and without hope for the future. Lift their weights from them, that they may let go of their pasts and fears. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those worn down by pain, grief, or by a sense of uselessness, for those whom society does not want or value, for the elderly, the infirm, and for the sick and those in need. We name those who have asked for our prayer: Arthur, Elizabeth, Sister Gloria, Jim and Rose. Soothe their hurt, calm their distress, that they may find their presence and peace in you. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember all who have died in your love, especially those dear to us, and those from this parish whose yearly memorial occurs at this time. Oswina O'Sullivan, Brian Webb, William Smith, the priest, Elizabeth Gordon, Clifford Burnett, Douglas Armstrong, Robert Shillaby, Robert Crawford. In life, teach us to follow the example of your Son, that we may learn to share each other's burdens. And in death, bring us into your presence, that our souls may find eternal rest in you. Gracious God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Friends, we are the body of Christ. His spirit is with us. The peace of the Lord be always with you,
and also with you.
Oh,
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them
to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for our Saviour Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. And we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come, let us take this holy sacrament of the body and blood of Christ in remembrance that he died for us and feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. And for today, during this time when we're physically unable to receive the sacrament, receive the bread and wine, let us pray together the prayer for spiritual communion. Please join me in the words that you'll see on your screen. A prayer for spiritual communion. Almighty God, I believe that you are truly present in this holy sacrament. And since I cannot at this time receive communion, I pray you to come into my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all my heart, my soul, and my mind. Let nothing separate me from you. Let me serve you in this life until by your grace I come to your glorious kingdom and unending peace. Amen. Body of Christ, the blood of Christ. Let us pray. Living God, in this holy meal you fill us with new hope. May the power of your love, which we have known in word and sacrament, continue your saving work among us. Give us courage for our pilgrimage and bring us to the joys you promise. Most loving God, you send us into the world you love. Give us grace to go thankfully and with courage in the power of your Spirit. Friends, the peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go now in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.